Fastlane killed it. I mean, going in, I wasn't too sure. I mean, the overall car was looking like, I don't know, man. It's like, I know that the main event was going to steal the show, but there was a lot of spots in the pay-per-view that really stood out. I mean, we have a new U.S. champion. We have a tag team that was not even part of the match card that completely destroyed everybody in their path. That was awesome. I'm going to get into that once we get a little bit later on. Right here, Randy Orton. Man is going into WrestleMania as the United States champion, right? It was kind of slow in the start, I will say that, but it didn't take long for these guys to pick it out. Bobby Roode, he wanted to take some chances, right? Went to the top turnbuckle. Randy Orton, unpredictable Orton. He caught him out of nowhere, right? RKO. That's all it took was one, right? One, two, three, and we all know who was going to show up. I'm actually kind of shocked that he didn't show up in the middle of the match and interfered and cost one of these two the match. But Jinder Mahal, he came out, he attacked Randy Orton. Bobby Roode's like, nah, bro, I gotcha. Got him with the glorious DDT, right? And not only Jinder Mahal, but I mean, the guy was upset. The man lost his title, so it was only right that he got Orton with it at the end. So this has kind of been the match in the making, right? For the last month, this is what they've been building up for, right? WrestleMania, the triple threat match between Jinder Mahal, Bobby Roode, and Randy Orton. I am glad that Randy Orton won this. I mean, this has really given one of these two guys the opportunity to step up at WrestleMania and get the WrestleMania moment, right? Capture the U.S. title on the grandest stage of them all. I mean, Orton, dude, you've been in the business for so long. I mean, I think it is time, right? Don't hang up your boots yet. That's not what I'm saying. But give one of these guys the opportunity to kind of solidify themselves as one of the top superstars of SmackDown. So pretty hyped for that. I'm sure they'll announce it come Tuesday night. It's not official yet, but I can almost guarantee that. Right here, Strong Style, right? Shinsuke Nakamura, he got the pay-per-view started in a big way, right? He took on Rusev Day, right? Aiden English was there. I thought this was going to be like a 3, maybe 5 minute match. But Rusev, he gave it his all. He took Shinsuke Nakamura to the limit. I mean, this was a pretty good match. I got to say, I'm really pleased. But there was no way that Rusev was going to capture the win. I'm actually kind of shocked that Aiden English didn't interfere in the match. I thought he was going to do something towards the end. It just really cost, you know, not necessarily the match, but do something to kind of like make Shinsuke looks stronger. But no, they let Rusev do his thing, right? He went out there, he did this thing, but didn't take long, right? Kinshasa, right? Two of them. That was it. You get one, you're like, I don't know, maybe I'll kick out of 3. But once you get 2, that pretty much makes it official. So really hyped. And once I get into the main event, oh, you guys, this is our dream basically coming true, right? Our rematch from Wrestle Kingdom 10. But that's another story. I don't want to spoil it for you if you haven't. No spoilers, right? No spoilers in the middle of the video right here. The Usos taking on the New Day right here. Big E, he was at ringside. He was cheering on for his team. He's like, come on, guys. But here's the thing, you guys. Even though these guys were putting on a great show, it didn't take long. It was inevitable, right? It was inevitable for the Monsters to come out and basically do what they were not necessarily telling them for the last couple of months, but we all know, right? They were coming out. They were not interfering, but just kind of saying, hey, you guys, we're coming after you, right? They've been coming after jobbers. They've just been destroying jobbers left and right, but they came out and they attacked the main SmackDown tag team talent, right? They literally destroyed not just the Usos, but the New Day. They left them scattered all throughout the arena. They actually ended up even putting Xavier Woods on the stretcher. They did this devastating powerbomb on the steel steps. Oh man, it looked gruesome. It was just like, it was pure savagery. That's probably the best way to put it. As Xavier was, I hope you're all right, man. That powerbomb looked nasty. These guys right here, they're going into WrestleMania. We'll find out come Tuesday for sure. But these guys are going to go into WrestleMania. And I don't know, will they capture the titles? I'm going to leave that up to you guys. Drop that in the comment section. Pretty hyped to see what these guys are going to do with like the actual, not jobbers, but the actual talent, right? Speaking of the tag team matches, we had Carmella and Natalya taking on Becky Lynch and Naomi. Yes, so of course we all know that the briefcase, it was going to be used at one point, right, in the match. And of course, I mean, it wasn't to hit Becky Lynch over the head, but it was enough distraction for Carmella to get this really, it was almost, you can almost call it like Shawn Michaels, like pure sweet chinness, man. She got her with this nice super kick, and that was it. It was 1, 2, 3. I mean, the match didn't carry on that long, and it is good because these two, we definitely need them later on in the night, right? the women's champion. She was taking on Riot Squad. And it was a numbers game, right? We all know that it was going to be a handicap match. But they ended up coming out and kind of just, you know, like, we got your back. Don't worry. We're going to help you out. They really didn't do much. They actually ended up getting kicked out eventually. And, yeah, she still kept. We all know that she was going to retain, right? Because we all know that this was going to happen. The Empress of Tomorrow, she came out at the end of the match. She's like, oh, congrats. She didn't congratulate her. But she came out and she had to do her thing, right? Basically did what Ronda did a month ago. She pointed at the sign, letting her know that this was going to go down at WrestleMania, right? Charlotte against the Empress of Tomorrow. So we're going to get this. So pretty excited. I mean, like, there was no promo. She smiled at the end of it. She's like, ah, yeah, I'm ready for her. I don't think you're ready for her. I don't think anybody is ready for Asuka. Now, right here, the six-pack. Sorry, it was five. Actually, it was a fatal four. Then it was five. And then they eventually turned it into a six-pack challenge, right? Shane McMahon, came out, he ended up sitting at ringside, right? We all know that he was going to play an important factor of the overall outcome of this main event, right? John Cena, right? He was taking on pretty much the entire gang. That's what happened in the beginning. He was literally giving all these guys the F5, not all at the same time, but you can imagine it, right? John Cena, one right after the other on all of them. But AJ Styles, he stood strong in the middle of the ring. He's like, not me, bro. So, like, this match right here, gotta say, it was awesome. This, you can almost compare this. Well, I don't know if you can compare this, because that Iron Man match, well, it wasn't an Iron Man, but that Gauntlet match on Monday night a few weeks ago with Seth Rollins, I think that's what they were trying to do. They were trying to outdo Raw, right? A lot of great just chain wrestling from everybody. I mean, everybody was getting their licking, right? We're getting some pop-up power bombs. Here's the thing. Kevin Owens, this was kind of like the one point that really stood out. Before I get into that, though, AJ Styles, he ended up getting put through the table by John Cena, through the announcer table. And that kind of just, oh, man, it made you wonder. It's like, wait, AJ Styles is done? He's out? Oh, we're going to get a new champion for sure, right? We'll get into that once towards the end of the match. KO. He ended up accidentally giving the sweet chin to Shane McMahon, right? And Shane McMahon, he was not happy. I mean, he was so upset. Like, once he regained consciousness, he ended up interfering in the match. KO was about to go for the pin. He pulled him out, right? Sammy was going to do the same. He pulled Sammy out, and that kind of just basically put them in a tough situation. Like, there's no way that either of these two guys were going to win, right? AJ Styles eventually came in, right? Like, I think it was literally towards the end. He got taken out in the beginning, got put through the announcer table. But he got that phenomenal forearm on Kevin Owens, right? And we all know that this was going to happen, right? Come on. There's no way that they're not going to give us AJ Styles versus Shinsuke Nakamura right here at WrestleMania. This is so cool. What's going to happen with Cena, though? That's my question, right? I mean, this was literally his only chance to get his WrestleMania shot at anything, really. I mean, he doesn't have anything left. And I know I told you guys that Undertaker was going to show up. I still think Taker's going to show up. He didn't show up tonight. Hopefully Tuesday night. Hopefully Monday night. One of these two nights, it's got to happen. Because as of right now, Cena, he has absolutely nothing going on. But that's all right. You know why? Because we're getting that dream match that I was talking about in the beginning of the video. Shinsuke Nakamura versus AJ Styles. Wrestle Kingdom 10 all over again. Oh, this is so sick. I'm still shocked that he pulled. I mean, I'm sure everybody thought that it was over for AJ Styles. But this right here, so hyped for this, you guys. Until next time, everybody.